Ladies and gentlemen, a momentous occasion for this country. Gay marriage is now legal in all 50 states. Across the entire U.S. of A, gay marriage is now legal. States can no longer deny gay couples their right to marry. A momentous occasion, a landmark day. Now, I know I give conservative Christians and anti-gay people in general, bigots, homophobes, I know. I give them a lot of shit. I've given them a lot of shit over the years. And I'm just gonna keep on going. Screw you, you lose. And how does it taste? How does it feel? Kentucky, Florida, Tennessee, Georgia, Arkansas, Alabama, North Carolina, South Carolina, Virginia, West Virginia, Texas, Oklahoma. How does it feel knowing that you can no longer deny same-sex couples the right to marry? Oh my God, you can almost just hear Republicans collectively shitting all over themselves. When this news broke, I can imagine Rush Limbaugh probably popped blood vessels in his eyes. I just imagine Glenn Beck, oh my God, this is not only good for this country because it's another step toward humanity, because it's another step towards catching up with the rest of the civilized world, but just the sheer entertainment that this is going to bring from all of these Republicans who have fought so long, who have fought so hard to try to keep gay marriage out of the state. Well, you know what? You got no fucking choice now. And I know you're going to start bitching about freedom. Oh, it's our freedom. No, if you really cared about freedom, if you really gave a shit about freedom, you would give these people the freedom to marry whoever the fuck they want. That is freedom, not giving a shit who they marry, because it doesn't affect you, and you know it. You know for a fact it has never affected you. Gays getting married has never affected your ability to lead a long, healthy, salubrious, prosperous life. Never. Not one single thing about gay marriage has affected you at all, but you've kept trying to deny it. You can't do it anymore. This is real freedom. This is real freedom, conservatives. We got a long way to go, but you know what? This is a huge, huge, huge fucking thing. You lose, you fucking dinosaurs. It's time to start okay, I was gonna say it's time to start changing your minds. Nothing's ever gonna change your mind, even this. You're gonna shit and piss and cry and whine and snot and snivel about this until the end of fucking time. And you know what? You wanna know the first page I went to when this news dropped? The first page I went to, Josh Feuerstein, you useless fucking pig. I see you, Feuerstein, you useless fucking pig, talking about how this is a conservative holocaust. Are you fucking kidding me? These are the kinds of people that are against gay marriage. These were the kinds of people, this exact rhetoric, these were the people stifling gay marriage, trying to keep gays from marrying, people who are going to come out after gay marriage is legalized and say that this is going to be the Christian Holocaust. 10,000 pastors said that if gay marriage ever got legalized in this country, that they would kill themselves. See you later, bye-bye, bye-bye, leave this earth with some fucking grace. I'm telling you, I wish I had a police scanner. You know how they have police scanners where you can listen to like the police talk and chatter and, you know, beat up innocent people. I want to get a scanner. I want to create a scanner that can tune into Republican frequencies and just listen to all of the fucking butthurt, all of the rage, all of the indignation. Just it's gonna, Fox News. Oh my God, Fox News is probably a madhouse runner. They're scrambling to find ways to tell everybody that they're aging, fucking old, borderline mentally retarded viewer base about how this is going to be the end of the world. How this is going to be the end of time, the end of days. Gays are getting married. Oh my fucking God. You know what? I can only say so much more about this. This is amazing. This is awesome. All you conservatives out there, thank you for the entertainment. Thank you for the entertainment for days and weeks and months and years to come. I appreciate it. I appreciate your stupidity. I appreciate your ignorance. I appreciate your bigotry. But you know what? You lost, and you lost big time. That's all I got to say about that.